when a plan comes together. I have a lot to cover in this rant, so let's not waste time with a lot of extra framing. A literal New World Order is being put in place right now. It has taken decades to create, and very powerful people are moving the final pieces across the board. This is not an exaggeration or panic-inducing statement being made by a garden-variety conspiracy nut. If the NWO stays the course and creates no extra chaos, they can transform this country and others to follow in 3 moves. 4 if they want to make a statement, 5 if they want to be flashy or greedy. Time will tell. I'm going to give you the next 3 moves and what to expect moving forward from now into the next year. This is not because I snuck out some classified documents while working at an Illuminati think tank. It's based on everything I have researched and absorbed from history and media so far, and it is also what I would do if I were an agent. So pay attention. One way or another, this will affect you. My biggest qualifier for a conspiracy is the inability to improve upon any given plan. The moves that the Order have made so far and what they foreshadow are, from what I can see, nearly perfect. I consider myself a very clever person, and looking at the end goal, I can see no other options. It's like being in check during chess. When you're in it, your responses become very limited. Please keep in mind that everything you have seen on the news so far is just to tick off compliance boxes. This is not about a virus. The virus story was just to give them a reason to ask you to wear a mask. The masks were just to see if you would suffer an inconvenience. You were restricted to see what you would do if just your basic needs were met, and most of the country adjusted without much incident, or so you thought. It's the second week of July 2020. The next move will roll out slowly over several months. It will not be decisive, more of a precursor to the main event. Several companies will come forward touting a vaccine, and the antibody success rate will eventually approach 99%, if not 99.9%. The short version is that the first move will be the vaccine light at the end of the tunnel. It's a promise, a savior, a release from the self-imposed lockdown. Medical doctors will vouch for it, and the government will announce that when it comes, it will be free and widely available. Although there will be some debate over who gets it first. But this is only the first step, that it's coming soon, and we'll all be saved. The second move is a massive corporate celebrity and media endorsement, because with the vaccine, your life will return to normal. All the luxuries that have been stripped away from you for months will be liberated, announcing that everything will be reinstated if you take the injection. This second move is by far the most important for the general public. Announcing a successful antibody vaccine in advance gives people hope. But the endorsements validate and realize it, making it tangible. You can almost taste the freedom. Every corporation that has been partially shut down will embrace the coming vaccine because they now have the chance to generate maximum revenue again. And the companies that produce the goods and services you want the most, they will be the loudest. This will include the NFL, NBA, baseball, movie theaters, concerts, museums, conventions, conferences, casinos, etc. Any form of escapism that you once subscribed to will now be available to you once again. And all these wonderful distractions that you loved, cherished, and worshipped will be waiting for you. At a nominal cost, of course. The media will then launch a pro-injection campaign blitz like you have never seen. Every day will be stories of hope and a return to normalcy as institution after institution climbs on board the vaccine train. The kids will be able to go back to elementary, middle, high school, and universities. The beaches and all parks will become unrestricted again. You will be able to travel domestically without checkpoints, and internationally, well, we will get to that. People will be excited again, optimistic about getting their life back and the future. And this is the name of the prize they will dangle in front of you, your life back. Everything that has been kept from you will now be returned for a small and very reasonable ransom. And most of the people you see walking the streets will not even resist, because it's easy. Like all great plans. The general public will instinctively understand it at first glance. The order has kept people in the dark for months. Nowhere to go, nothing to do, money is tight, and prospects are bleak. People are so currently restless, they riot in the streets because it's something social they are allowed to do. And they have nothing else on their dance card. Dance cards used to be a thing, by the way. Think about this from the average person's point of view, someone who doesn't want to hear the truth, who doesn't believe in any conspiracies, no matter how small. These people will knock each other over for the injection. You thought the Costco lines were long? That was toilet paper. Standing in line to get your life back will be bigger than the new iPhone, and almost as rewarding as having Oprah give you a new car for going to her show. That was a thing too. 1986, look it up. Mainstream will hover outside as the first people get their vaccines, amplifying their enthusiasm, reinforcing the narrative. You'll hear the usual words and catchphrases repeated again and again about how relieved they are. Couldn't wait to get back to normal, and so happy that everything is going to be the way it was before. But it's not going to be like it was. Not exactly. You knew there was going to be a catch, right? As first-year economic professors are fond of saying, there is no such thing as a free lunch. I never really liked that quote. What they should be saying is that everything has a cost. Remember that this isn't about cases or deaths or even testing. This is about compliance. The vaccine will be offered to everyone, tested or not, for free. And the price will sound small, that being confirmation. Confirmation is the third move. The third move in this whole process is authentication, meaning proof that you have gotten the shot. This isn't like lying to the doctor when you say you've had your tetanus injection. This one has to be authenticated. It has to be registered into an international database. It's the only way to close all the loopholes and exploits that people would create. Without confirmation, everyone would just say they got the vaccine. They would lie. Not because they are bad people, they would do it out of laziness. Most of the general population wasn't scared enough during the initial numbers to even drive a few miles out of their way for testing. Getting a cure only motivates someone if it's mandatory. It's this third move which is oh so clever. You see, by requiring authentication of the vaccine, you give people a double reward, in that you give them their lives back and they get to take off their mask. Meanwhile, the roles are then reversed for the other side. The option for those who do not want the shot will then be given the option of wearing a mask. Before, the masks were seen as a sign of citizen compliance, and the majority of people wore them. Once the vaccine is released, masks will be seen as non-compliance and only worn by the minority. To add insult to injury, it will be a double punishment. People who never wore masks because of their ability to see the truth will now be forced to wear the very thing they made fun of. The mask of the sheeple now becomes the mask of the awoken. I know what you're thinking. You're defiant. You won't take the shot or wear the mask. You're right, the mark system has certain limitations, especially in rural areas. You will be able to walk the streets without wearing a mask, and no one would know, until you decide to purchase something, or attend an event, or enter some buildings. Take grocery stores, for example. You could walk around the aisles with the compliance, but when you went through the checkout, something different would happen. You would either have to show proof of immunity, or you would have to be wearing a mask. If you put on the mask at the register, the crowd around you would voice their displeasure, see it as dishonest and hazardous. And it would continue like this indefinitely. Let's say you went to a football game. You would need the mask to get in. You could take it off once inside, provided that no one saw you do it. Then you would just have to deal with concessions. Maybe bathrooms. It depends on what sort of electronics have been installed. which brings me to the last detail of the third move, which I left out. The verification process is going to be new and electronic, and it's going to change everything. It's going to create a new world, so to speak. So how would you do it? How do you create a medical authentication process that's easy to understand, easy to use, and difficult to forge? ID cards can be forged, same goes with bracelets. Even phone apps are vulnerable to counterfeit, just use someone else's phone. The only way to be sure is to have a unique number attached to a person, generated by the system, maybe even something that can be updated. I know my audience, and I know what you're thinking. It's the chip. The one that we've been hearing about year after year, but up until now it's been more myth than monster. Yes, a skin-based medical software tracking system makes the most sense. I have no reason to think otherwise. If I had to choose a system, this would be it. I would design a tiny SIM card that could be updated and couple it with a 3D barcode using invisible ink, something that would display easily with a grocery store scanner. This system will be announced just before the vaccine goes live, and it will have a non-threatening name if they could pull it off. Something like VaxTrax, SafeTrack, SmartMark, AuthentiSafe, maybe MedSecure. You get what I mean. If they use one of those, don't hate me. I didn't attend all the meetings. And yes, if they implement this system, it has all the qualifications of the mark from Revelation. But that speech comes later as things solidify. The mark is not something you can easily get around. It's not something you can solve by digging in your heels, mostly because it's different from, say, not complying with the mask. There is no medical reason to refuse the vaccine. The peer pressure around you will increase over time, and some people who initially stand their ground will give in because their peer groups will shrink. To the general public, the only people who refuse the mark will do so because they are either anti-vaxxers or religious objectors. As far as I can tell, there is no third option. I won't go deep into the religious aspects here, only to say that Revelation 13 and 14 are no joke, and they are specific. The point is that there won't be much sympathy from the general public or the media. If you choose not to comply, then you are a rebel, a dissenter. You're not part of the solution, you're part of the problem. To make matters worse, you're now wearing a mask. Well, maybe. That might create a new wrinkle. Many banks have already put special conditions in to not allow people into the main lobby with a mask. Does that mean that you have to go to the drive-thru to conduct your business? I'm not saying that eventually you'll have to use different drinking fountains, but I'm sure you can see a slippery slope forming. Again, this isn't a perfect system, and there will be resistance, so you won't be alone. There are policies that will be fluid. At what age do you vaccinate children? The schools will no doubt champion this policy, starting with first grade at the very least. Is the system too invasive? Yes, there will be numerous groups that will address this, but most will be drowned out by the rebounding economy and the new good times. Also note that it doesn't matter who wins the election, because both candidates will back the mark system. It's required. The public demands it. They want to work. They want to play. Mostly they want to have the freedom to have fun again. Conservatives probably don't want to hear this, but give it some thought. If Trump wins, the vaccine guarantees him an improving economy and nothing but potential growth for his entire term. There isn't anything more important to a politician than happy voters. Also, don't forget that this is an international program. Most of the countries of the world have had to deal with the virus, and despite their differences, will all agree to adopt the same system. International flights will reflect that unity. Again, it may seem discriminatory if you refuse border entrance based on vaccine confirmation, but try to get that reversed. Legal issues become tricky when dealing with other countries. The short version is that if you don't have the mark, you are a potential threat to other nations and you are not getting in. Could I be wrong about all this? It is possible that the Order will just implement a worldwide vaccine without a tracking system. Of course, it's possible. This particular virus, like the masks, may just be a warm-up for a second virus, but considering how well this one did, and how long it usually takes to roll out a vaccine, real or not, it seems like a wasted opportunity from the Order's standpoint. The challenge I put to you, the listener, as we end this rant, is to think about the decisions you will have to make in the near future instead of hoping for the best and saying that the worst will never happen. What will you do if the vaccine turns into something more? What steps will you take if you disagree with a medical mark? How far are you willing to go? What are you willing to do without? Because not complying will have a cost, like all things do. I don't have all the answers. No one does. I can't speak for you and your particular situation. You may have a spouse or children, and you may like your job and where you currently live. All these things will play a part in what's to come. This is just a warning, a heads up to what might be in store for the world that we know. The warning for the religious objectors comes later and only if the system is fully revealed. I'll leave you with a short segment from a kids' cartoon series made by Netflix in 2018. The episode is called Masters of Order, and the system is called Smart Mark. It's an interesting message for children growing up in strange times. Some of you will see it as a simple animation that means nothing, but some of you will know better.
Charter City is stunned by the sudden rollout of Rook Unlimited's most fantastic device ever. The Smart Mark. Throw your other devices away, because the Smart Mark is more than just a phone. It's part of you. Use it as cash. Book your travel. And even shoot video. Distribution points are all over the city. And don't let the lines discourage you. The Rook Unlimited Smart Mark is worth the wait.
I never realized how wonderful technology could make me feel. The Smart Mark has brought order to my life.
And the best part? It's absolutely free. A gift of thanks to our city from Rook Unlimited. Yeah!